It is weekly update time. We're talking track and field, the outdoor side of things, with the director of the program, Rod DeHaven. And as we discussed last week, a lot of individuals competing multiple places and a ton of solid performances. The headliner, though, Reed Pierzynski, breaks his own record in the 400-meter hurdles. What a job he did down in Fayetteville.
Yeah, the intent of going to Arkansas was, of course, to get weather that was pleasant, spring-like. Unfortunately, we did not get that. But that being said, Reed went out, season opener, and really shattered his own school record, and it's a mark that sits top 25 nationally and leads the Summit League and, somewhere safely within the top 48 of the West Regional. And, hats off to him. He's worked very hard. Certainly, I think he's still erasing some of the disappointment of his own individual 400 at the conference meet, and went a long way to kind of put that in the rearview mirror. So, hats off to him. And despite the conditions in Arkansas, I think we competed very well. Maybe all the marks don't necessarily show that, but a couple shot putters that throw 54 feet, get outdoor personal best there. The jumps, it was cold, windy, so the marks don't look good, but I think in some cases did very well with that. We've got the stick around the men's 4x1 and women's 4x1. And those are victories that you don't necessarily get out the band and the cheerleaders for that. But, those are things that, start to build momentum, for the rest of the season. Dealing with that and, big time environment, SEC school. I think we competed well down there and, just of course wish the weather was a little bit different.
But to your point, conference championships aren't won on weekends like this. It happens later, but you have to build and you have to perform in situations like that. So to build, to make those steps, last weekend was a big weekend.
Yeah, it was a big weekend, and we were fortunate too to get another competition in over at Minnesota State Mankato, and appreciative of the Mavericks for letting us hop in the fray there. And I think we got a lot accomplished there, and some breakthrough type stuff that occurred when you look at a Connor Powers, nearly going 6'8", young man that I think he was consistently 6'2", and he knows that that's not really super competitive within the Summit League. Now he's emerged as somebody who's potentially can be on the podium if he can continue this kind of momentum going forward. And, got some stuff, some PRs in the throws, and their conditions on Friday were absolutely horrible, but did some nice things there. And, got some stuff done on the track. Lauren Van Dyke comes back from her horrific injury indoors and runs very well in the 400 and the 4x4. And, largely it was a very, very productive day and very proud of how our student athletes approach that situation over there at Mankato.
I know, like you, I was a fan of Wide World of Sports growing up, and Jim McKay's line of spanning the globe. It feels like your program will be spanning the globe here in the next few days.
It's kind of the rituals of spring as it relates to track and field in the Midwest. Certainly we had some different plans for the group locally. The weather week is going to be rough. As though Mother Nature's humming Niccolo's cruel to be kind. She'll eventually, repay us, I'm sure, right at the end of the season. But right now it's time to be cruel. And, so we'll probably have a group of throwers that'll compete over at a hardy group of throwers that'll be over at St. Thomas, because conditions won't be, perfect, but well enough to, get some of those events in. And then we'll take a healthy group of student athletes to Southern California for a trifecta of meets at Long Beach State, then Mount Sac Relays, and Brian Clay meet at Azusa Pacific that'll have over 5,000 athletes. So it'll be a circus, to say the least. So, yeah, and that group, we're looking for big things. It's, going after regional marks, school records, top 10 type stuff, top of the Summit League. Those are the types of things that we are going after this particular weekend.
Well, hopefully we can avoid Bananarama and a cruel summer, Coach.
Yeah, of course. We do not want a cruel summer, but it's been a interesting month of April so far, and I'm sure things will improve as they always do. Just wait a minute, as they like to say.